Koka Nikolatze ist Komponist und leidenschaftlicher Bastler. Das Bauen von Beatmaschinen ist für den Wahlnorweger eigentlich nur ein Hobby. Vier seiner kuriosen Kreationen gibt es bisher.
This is beat machine number one. It basically sounds like this. So this is a hand cranked device. You can see a ruler here, a piece of wood with some springs. There is some rice inside this box. Another spring, some brass, again a safety pin, a fork.
Die Alltagsgegenstände für seine Maschinen findet Koka zu Hause oder bei Bitref, einem offenen Hackerwerkraum in Oslo.
I hang out here quite a lot. This is the place where I find most of my materials. This is one of the most beautiful springs I've seen in my lifetime.
Jede Schöpfung ist einzigartig und komplexer als die vorherige.
It's basically a standalone unit. You just move this fader and you click the switch. And then I can morph between different rhythms by moving another fader. I can enable or disable different elements by using these four switches. No snare drum. Snare drum. Do you like it, Novi?
In Norwegen ist die Bastelkunst des umtriebigen Komponisten nicht unbemerkt geblieben. Seit 2017 ist eine seiner Beatmaschinen sogar für die Öffentlichkeit ausgestellt.
Right now we're at the Museum of Pop Culture in Oslo. I sometimes come here to have a look at this creature. This one is called Beat Machine Number 3. It has its own history, right? Objects that are attached to it. To me that's really important because the cola bottle that you see here, this was actually sitting on my table for quite a while. The cola inside is not fake. It's just, you know, taken from that table and then put here. For me personally, it's a frozen moment in time that I just took a snapshot of that particular moment and put it on the machine. My bicycle keys are here. The ping pong ball, it actually belonged to Moby. It still has Moby's tooth prints on it. And the fork is from our kitchen again.
Koka ist neugierig und ehrgeizig, hat eine Leidenschaft für Tanzmusik. All das treibt seine Kreativität an. Bei Bitref konnte er außerdem so viel Know-how sammeln, dass seine Beatmaschinen technisch immer eindrucksvoller werden.
This is the fourth beat machine. You can see each of these little platforms are made of contact microphones, so that the small objects attached to them get directly amplified. There are the needles of tiny voltmeters. And then when I send a signal, they get triggered, so they hit the objects that are attached. This is a spring that I removed from an oversized pen. There is a metal pin that I use as a bass drum. There is a morphine capsule, right, that I use as a snare drum. There is a guitar string. And when you amplify it, the small insignificant sounds that you can barely hear turn into something like this. Right now I'm working on the beat machine number 5. I'm planning to make it out of a glass can. A lot of my friends suggested making a proper production with beat machines, and I thought it was a very good idea, so my plan is to build several more of those. I planned that for 2019, and hopefully by the end of 2019 there will be a beat machine album in collaboration with some of my favorite artists.